Welcome, everybody. I'm Crystal Huang, and I'm on the Google Assistant Product Partnerships team. I'm here today with Toni and Madhukar. We're super excited as Google Assistant continues to deepen its collaboration with Android to create a more seamless experience for developers and users. Today, we're going to highlight how users can employ Google Assistant for conversational, personalized help to get things done across different devices, and how developers are able to fulfill those requests with integrations based on Android platform features and APIs in order to minimize work across Android device types. Before we dive into those details, let's take a brief look at what it means for Assistant and Android to be better together and why it matters, both for users who are looking for seamless experiences across different devices and for developers who are looking to lower development costs for different device types by using common development and testing tools. Let's start with users. We can do so much with technology today, so it's no wonder that many of us are adding more and more computing devices to our homes. For example, in 2019, the average US household had 11 connected devices. In 2021, that went up to 25. With this proliferation of devices, it's more important than ever that they work better together, so users don't have to learn a bunch of new interfaces, or remember which capabilities work on which devices, or pull up the same content or task over and over again as they move from one device to the next. Google Assistant is a key ingredient that enables devices to work better together because it provides this really natural, intuitive interface for accelerating a user's tasks across their apps and devices. Think of Assistant as the glue that provides a consistent, voice-forward user experience and enables a user to jump straight to the most relevant or useful point in their apps. Assistant does this by understanding which capabilities apps support and which apps are best able to fulfill users' requests. This applies whether users already have the app installed or not, whether they make their requests through voice or by touch, and whether those requests are simple commands or complex multi-step journeys. Now that we've talked about benefits for users, let's talk about what this means for our developers. It's never been easier to integrate your Android apps with Google Assistant by taking advantage of Android shortcuts and media APIs. These enable fast, natural entry points to content and features in not only your mobile app, but also Android TV OS, Android for Cars, and Wear OS apps. We're working to provide a consistent developer experience across different device types to ease the effort of voice enabling your app wherever it runs. And next up is Madhukar. I'm going to hand it over to him to go through the details.
Thanks, Crystal. I'm Madhukar Srivastava, and I'm a product manager on the Google Assistant team. We introduced Assistant in 2016 on voice-activated smart speakers, then brought Assistant to many other devices. We heard from our developers that you appreciated being able to build experiences for new types of devices, such as smart speakers and displays, tablets, and other smart home devices. Many of you were looking for ways to integrate voice, proactive, and other assistive capabilities into your existing Android content and experiences without having to learn a new platform or build from scratch. That's why we launched App Actions, enabling developers to extend Android apps to Assistant on smartphones so simple voice commands can open key app functionality. We have continued to harmonize the App Actions development experience with the Android platform, so it takes less effort to implement App Actions while adding support for App Actions to surface on more device types, so there are greater benefits from the same core implementation. Let's explore how App Actions work, then examples of how the implementation can extend to different Android devices. Google Assistant improves the Android user experience by enabling users to naturally invoke apps with voice or touch, whichever modality is most convenient at that moment. Like voice commands when your hands are full or you are multitasking. To apply this functionality to an Android app, developers can use App Actions to get started with voice journeys in their apps. Let's think about two main steps required for users to access your app's features through voice commands to Assistant. First, we need to process the user's spoken input and understand their request. Second, we need to fulfill the user's requests. There are many variations on how people might express the same intent using conversational language. Assistant uses natural language understanding technology to identify different speech patterns that correspond to the same particular functionality. We've already modeled speech patterns for more than 60 use cases, which we call built-in intents, or BIIs. These include use cases that apply broadly to most apps, like opening a feature or updating an account. They also include use cases that are primarily applicable to apps in a specific category, like ordering a menu item for food and drink apps. For functionality unique to your app that's not covered by a built-in intent, app actions also support the creation of custom intents. To tell Assistant about your app's functionality, you can update your app bundle to declare which built-in or custom intents your app can handle. You can also define any parameters to expect in the user's queries. Once Assistant has matched a user's request to the functionality that you have told us your app can handle, we need to fulfill the request. Assistant can do this in two ways, based on how you define fulfillment instructions for each intent you support. The first launches your app with an Android intent that contains parameters extracted from the user's query, which fast-tracks the user to the appropriate spot in your app to complete the rest of the journey. The second displays an Android widget from your app within Assistant, which provides a quick inline response. You can also add a spoken response to your widget to give it a more conversational feel. Because Assistant handles natural language modeling to understand users' requests, then uses existing components of your app, like Android intents and widgets, to fulfill those requests, developers can enable app actions and the added benefit to users quickly. Adding voice-first functionality to your app through app actions creates a more simple, streamlined interaction, minimizing the friction for users. These app actions are available across multiple devices where Assistant exists today, and users expect Assistant features to work seamlessly in every context. Let's take a closer look at how Assistant leverages your app action implementation to provide hands-free or proactive experiences across multiple types of Android devices, like phones, cars, watches, and others. Plus a few examples of what developers have created. Over to you, Toni.
Thanks, Madhukar. I'm Toni Klopfenstein, a developer relations engineer for Google Assistant. Madhukar highlighted how Assistant can make the experience of using apps on phones better by accelerating tasks that might otherwise be hard to find or require multiple steps. However, we heard from our developers that it's tricky to communicate to your users that a helpful new way to access in-app functionality now exists. For example, if a user asked Assistant for functionality that your app can handle, but didn't say the name of your app in their query, or didn't have your app installed, Assistant wasn't able to help them. To improve this, we've launched more ways for Assistant to get users to your app so you don't need to worry about providing precise instructions to your users on how to use your app with Assistant. Two new features, Brandless Queries and App Install Suggestions, are now available immediately for all App Actions developers. When a user queries Assistant without using a specific app's brand name, also known as a brandless query, Assistant can now infer what app would best fulfill the user request and effectively route the user to that app. Let's see an example of this with Strava. If a user attempts to start logging their run without identifying Strava by name, Assistant will still identify the desired functionality and launch Strava to begin tracking a run. If a user triggers the proper Assistant query for the functionality of your app, even if the app isn't installed yet, then Assistant can provide app install suggestions. Assistant can automatically direct users to your Play Store listing and encourage them to install the app and access full functionality. Let's see how this looks when a user doesn't have the requested app installed. If a user says, show me recipes on TikTok, Assistant will open directly to the TikTok app Play Store page, encouraging installation. We've also improved custom intents as well. For apps using custom intents, such as schedule an appointment, machine learning-based grammar expansion can now automatically increase the number of queries Assistant identifies that can trigger an app, meaning developers don't have to manually model as many query patterns. These features are automatically available to users without any additional development work required on your mobile app. Now let's look at how an app actions implementation you launched for smartphones can be easily duplicated to apps developed for other types of Android devices. We're excited to announce that we are also extending app actions to Wear OS. When you're going for a run or a bike ride, chances are that you want to leave your phone in your pocket and keep your hands free. Your smartwatch is easily accessible, but the small screen makes it hard to touch and type or to digest a lot of information. That's where Assistant comes in, enabling users to issue voice commands to their Wear OS device and get glanceable information in return. The health and fitness BIIs used in your existing mobile apps will be enabled on Wear OS devices, meaning users can trigger the same expected integrations. Let's take a look at how this will work for a health and fitness app that has integrated app actions on Wear OS. Users will be able to launch the Assistant, say something like, "Start my run," to trigger the BII, and Assistant will launch that app feature automatically. Wearables aren't the only type of device where users may want or need a voice-first experience. Let's take a look at automotive applications. If you have a use case for your app that's also appropriate for use in cars, App Actions works there as well. Developers can add voice functionality to car apps by expanding their mobile App Actions implementation with the Car App Library. Once done, these apps can be used on either Android Auto or Android Automotive OS. Android Auto enables users to connect their Android phones to compatible vehicles and use their favorite apps and services right on the car's display. Android Automotive OS with Google built-in allows users to access Google Assistant, Google Maps, and apps from Google Play directly from the car display without the need for a phone. The Car App Library provides templates that can be used to build parking, charging, and navigation apps. These templates are designed with driver safety in mind, minimizing distractions with glanceable, voice-forward UIs that adapt to the vehicle they're running in. At this time, App Actions on Auto supports BIIs that are relevant to on-the-go use cases, finding parking, and charging. Let's take a look at how those BIIs work with our partner PlugShare. PlugShare allows users to find charging stations on the go. Here's a demo of the Android Automotive OS user experience where the user says, "Hey Google, find charging stations nearby on PlugShare." For developers who haven't built a specific Android Auto app but still want their Android mobile content to be available to their users in the car, you can use App Actions and Android widgets to provide quick answers and information on Android Auto and Android Automotive OS. This is great for on-the-go situations, like when you're driving home from picking up the kids, have a pizza coming for home delivery, and want to check how far out that pizza delivery is. App Actions are helpful for enabling voice commands in apps that find parking locations, charge stations, and more in the car. But what if users want to listen to your media app? If you've already built a media app, Google Assistant can also be used to bring voice-first functionality to your users. When you implement a media session for your audio or video app using the Media Session API, Assistant can access the transport controls for playback, allowing users to play, pause, skip, or discover what's playing, all through a voice query to their phone, tablet, automobile, or television. Developers can add this functionality to existing media sessions by setting flags for media and transport controls inside their media session. By using the existing media session transport controls within your app, Android will handle displaying controls for play, pause, seeking, or skipping to an adjacent piece of content, depending on which actions your media session supports. To learn more about media sessions, check out the TV space in IO Adventure. Wow, That's a lot of devices we just covered. You've now seen how developers can easily integrate voice functionality with the Android shortcuts and media APIs to create a seamless user experience with Assistant on different Android devices, including mobile, Wear, TV, and Auto. Don't forget to watch our other sessions, including our deep technical dive into Google Assistant's architecture, as well as our deeper dive into Assistant for Android Auto. If you're looking to get started building out your own Assistant integration on an Android device, check out the workshop that will walk you through integrating Android widgets with Google Assistant. Check out these additional resources to get started today, and don't forget, you can follow us on Twitter or sign up for the developer newsletter. Thanks for watching.